So let's say that you have to do a lot of typing where you repeat the same phrase often. For instance, in this example document you can see I've got this phrase, refer to page number X of report Y. And you can see I've repeated it here a few times. Maybe my work requires that I type this kind of thing over and over and over again, but with slightly different reference points here. So in this case, the page number and the report ID. So you want to be able to make this a little simpler. And there's some apps that you could purchase that would do that. But you could do it without those. One option is you can use System Preferences, and under Keyboard Text you can create a shortcut. And you probably already know this. I can do Report Ref. Let's see. Rep Ref is going to be this text which has blank lines here for refer to page number of report that. And if I do this and I want to insert another reference, I do rep ref and I hit space, I get the text there and I could type in something like that. But what if I wanted it to make it a little easier? If I wanted to actually have it prompt me for the missing pieces of information and then insert them so it automatically did it. You can do this using a little Automator script. So I'm going to run Automator and I'm going to create a new service. And then I'm going to set the service so that it receives no input. And I'm going to just put one thing in here, which is going to be a script. Now, I used to use AppleScript for this kind of thing, but JavaScript has kind of taken it over and it's a more modern language. So I'm going to use JavaScript instead. So I'm going to run JavaScript and put that in there, and I can type in my JavaScript right there. JavaScript is also called JXA. JavaScript for Automation. JXA kind of abbreviates that. And the script I'm going to put in here is pretty straightforward, but I'll explain it line by line as I paste it in. So the first part I want to paste in here is just some declarations. I'm going to declare a variable called app and set it to the current application. You pretty much need this for almost any JavaScript for Automation script that you create. Then I'm going to create another a variable called SE, which stands for System Events. And it's basically going to be a way for me to trigger system events. I'm going to use that to paste in the result. And then I'm going to, for the current app, include standard editions, set that equal to true. That's something that enables a lot of the automation stuff for whatever app you're running. Now I'm going to have it prompt me for the two pieces of information it needs. So the first one is it's going to set a variable called page number, and it's going to display a dialog. And it's going to ask for page number question mark with a default answer of blank. Now you may want to put something in here as a default answer. If like most of the time say it's page number 1, you may want to have it pre-filled in with 1 so you can just hit return. And then for report ID, I'm going to do the same thing. Ask for report ID with a default answer of blank. So it's going to actually come up with two prompts. I can test this at this point by hitting run. And you can see it's going to ask for page number. I'll say 4, report ID 78A. And it's done. So we know that part works. So now we want to assemble the text that we're going to paste in. So we're going to create a new variable called output, and we're going to put a bunch of strings together. So the first part is something defined by single quotes. It's just going to be parentheses, refer to page number with the space. Then the plus symbol to append strings to each other. Then page number dot text returned. Page number is actually going to get the result of display dialog, which includes a lot of information. We just want the text part of that. So text returned. Then we're going to add space of report space, and then report ID text returned. So the return value of this, and then close parenthesis and a period. Now all that's left is to paste that into place. So we will use set clipboard to set the clipboard, just like if we use Command C to copy, to the value from here. Then we're going to use the system events that we defined up here to do a system event, a keystroke, and press the V key using Command Down. So Command V, in other words, paste. And this will paste the text where the cursor is in whatever app we're using. So let's save. And it's going to automatically save the service in a place where it can be accessed throughout the system. So we just got to come up with a name. So we'll call this report reference. We'll save it. And we could see where it is here now. It's under Library Services Report Reference. That will mean that it can be accessed in any application by looking in the Services menu for Report Reference. So let's give it a try. So in Pages here, I've got my cursor ready to insert that text. I go to Pages, Services, Report Reference. It prompts me. And it inserts the text right there. So it's really easy to do. And I can go to System Preferences and make a keyboard shortcut for this. So go to Shortcuts, App Shortcuts, and I will add an app shortcut for Report Reference, which is the exact name in the menu. And I'll do like Command Shift F1. And now I can use that, Command Shift F1, and it prompts me. Now note that there's a tricky part here. If I go into Automator, you can see that sometimes I need to add these two lines to get it to work. After the clipboard is set, that works fine, but I notice that sometimes, perhaps because of something else I've got running on my Mac, this pasting doesn't work unless I tell it to specifically activate the application, even though it should already be running, and put a slight delay in there. So you may want to add these two if it's not working. Of course, this ties the script to a specific application, in this case Pages, which is fine because that's what I'm using here. So keep that in mind, that you may need to add those two to get it to work on your Mac.